Now you have to let's suppose 2, 2. We are having 3. We are having 3. We are having 4. We are having 5, 6. Then we are having 4. Let's suppose we are having 5. Now by joining the point, we get, we can find a graph. Let's suppose this is a graph of distance and time for linear motion. You see, from the graph, our graph gives a best fit line. What does this mean? This best fit line means that our velocity, the slope of x by time, the ratio of x by time is velocity. And this velocity is constant. Yes, by finding the slope, we see that slope is equal to x2 by x1. We suppose by time 2 minus time 1. Just the slope x is in meter. Yes, x is in meter by time in second. Now, we suppose we let t1, for example, looking on the points from our graph, let's find x1 is 4, t1, let's take t1 as 4, t2 as 5, then x1 as 4 meters, 5 seconds, for second, x1 as 4 meters, x2 as 5 meters. Then, by finding the slope S will be equal to 5 minus 4 by 5 minus 4. Here, meters, yes, second, not meter, but second. Then you find 1 meter per second. Our slope is velocity, which is equal to 1 meter per second from the graph. Now, by comparing the slope line by slope line, which is equal to x prime 2 minus x prime 1 by t prime 2 minus t prime 1, we suppose t prime 1 is equal to, we take 2 and 3, t prime is 2 seconds, t prime 2 is, let's suppose t3 seconds. Now x prime 1 is equal to 2 meters, x 2 prime is equal to 3 meters. Then we find the s prime, which is slope or velocity prime. Then we get x 2 prime by x 1 prime, dividing t2 prime minus t1 prime, which is 3 minus 2 meters by 3 minus 2 seconds, and we get 1 meter per second. As you see, the slope is constant. Here we have got 1, and here we have got 1. By comparing, we conclude that velocity is constant from the graph. Now what about the velocity? Velocity time graph. Velocity in meter per second and time in second. What about this? We not one, let's suppose 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's suppose 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we have a velocity which is constant. For the first second, it is 1. For the second, it is 1. For the third second, our velocity is mainly 1. Now, it shows that our velocity is constant. For the first second is 1. For the second, now velocity is 1. For the third second, it's also 1. We said that for URM, for URM, we conclude URM velocity is called constant. Now, what about acceleration? Acceleration, we are going to see how acceleration is equal to 0. We know that acceleration is equal to the change in velocity by the change of time. Now, how about velocity? Our velocity is 1 at the first point. Our velocity is 1. Let's do the difference of slope 1 prime minus slope now by time t1 by time t2. Now here we get 0 by change of time. Now we get 0 meter per second. This is how acceleration is 0. What about the graph of acceleration just in meter per second squared and time? What about this? Now acceleration is equal to 0. Let's suppose we are in time which is 1. Time in second, of course. Time which is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, the acceleration is equal to 1, 2, 3, and 4, and so on. Now we saw that our acceleration is equal to 0. How to put acceleration which is equal to 0 in graph? Now acceleration which is equal to 0, we put it like this. The graph showing acceleration which is equal to 0 is put here. Now bye bye. Thank you so much.
Thank you.